The unique S4 UFO seat box from Maver. European patented four-leg system. Adjustable frame height. Anti-memory, two-colour foam seat and pole support. Two round 30mm anodized accessory legs. State-of-the-art clip system, opening front and back. 40mm stacking module with lid, handle and two winder trays. Free flow sliding cassette footplate. One front and one side spirit levels. Large extendable 30mm legs and adjustable mud feet. Supplied with adjustable side tray, umbrella, keep net arms and a sturdy spray bar. In all, £150 worth of accessories, completely free of charge. The S4 UFO seat box is available in three different drawer configurations and is supplied with up to 40 pole winders. Technology not of this world.
To me, this competition's it's very important. It's tough to get into finals like this because there's so many good anglers. There's a lot of pressure to get through different venues. You need to draw good pegs.
It's the one that everybody wants to win.
I've been lucky enough to win Fishermania, so this is the next target. I want to be the next winner of Match This.
It's not the money, it's the prestige of winning such a big event. So yeah, it'd be fantastic to win this event.
Whoever wins this is going to be the biggest winner in match fishing history in England.
Over the last 4 years, Match This has established itself as one of the must-win competitions in the UK match angling calendar. Why? Well, for a start, there's a massive amount of credibility. Secondly, there's a massive £60,000 up for grabs. Competitors have fished in eliminators to get this far, and 24 of them are here today for Cup Final Day. This is Mega Match This. So Gary, business is relatively brisk this morning. Who's your favourite?
Well, we've had a couple of big market moves so far, Rob. We've had Mike McMillan. We started off at 10-1. He's now 3-1. Plenty of bangers and mash for Mike McMillan. And Jamie Hughes, oh, he's still the 3-1 favourite. But I've had Jamie Hughes before, a couple of years ago at Fishermania, if you can remember. And he took 9 months to get over that when he won Fishermania. So Jamie Hughes, the 3-1 favourite. Plenty of money for Mike McMillan.
Well, Jamie, another day, another dollar, and another big event for you.
Yeah, it's hopefully a good peg as well, Rob. I fancy the peg I've drawn today.
Happier than last year?
Yes, yeah, much happier. So it's a completely different lake up this end, a lot more fish, hopefully.
Well, the bookie seems to fancy you.
Yeah, Yeah, he's never very generous, Gary, ever since Fishermania last year.
No, he has mentioned it. He said he took it 9 months, I think, to recover from your exploits right there. But the form here on this lake at the moment is towards this end of the pond, isn't it?
Yes, generally. There tends to be a lot more carp up this end of the lake. Towards the early numbers is very good earlier in the year. Lots of F1 seem to feed down there. But later in the year, this becomes the more prolific area with some bigger fish.
Talk to me about tactics. What are you going to start off with?
To be honest, having seen fish down the edge straight away, I'm going to try and catch a couple of early fish. It might happen, it might not happen. And then it's going to be pretty much short, long. But I'm hoping that really my best bet is going to be down the edge. It might end up being an edge match for the whole match if other people are catching. I've got to try and make something happen, so it'll probably be an edge match, I think.
If the fishermen draw a good peg, 9 times out of 10 they'll be there fighting at 5 o'clock, and 60 grand this year. Fantastic, isn't it, what Phil's pulled up here? 60 grand, a lot of money to win in 5 hours, isn't it? 60 grand, 12 grand an hour that is, isn't it? We never get that making a book. You know us poor bookies, Rob, we never get anywhere near that.
If you've got to give a fiver to yourself, Gary,
yes,
where would it be going?
For five that are going, I'll be going on Jamie Hughes, because I think class, no matter what sport, always comes to the top. 3-1 Jamie Hughes, he'll be my section for my little fiver.
There we have it, competition is underway, and joining me on the bank with today's proceedings is a man that knows this venue very, very well indeed, Andy Kinder.
Hi,
Andy, thank you for joining me. What can we expect today? There's going to be fish all over the place.
I think there's going to be a lot of fish caught today, Rob. It's had some fantastic form last couple of weeks, big competitions, been won down the bottom end, it's been won at the top end. I can't really call where this is going to be won, and conditions are absolutely perfect today, really, really good.
Well, everybody seems to be up for it, and I don't think it's going to be long before there's fish on the bank.
No, I think you'll see these carp feeding pretty quickly. Like I said, they've been showing themselves, they've been jumping about all over, they really want to feed, and like I say, I think there'll be a big weight that wins it, really do.
Well, Andy, look at that, just seconds into the competition, that had hardly settled, and Lee Wright's in.
Yeah, he's drawn a really good peg, as Lee, and it looks like he's playing a carp. Well, he wants to hope it's a carp, Rob. Great peg here. He's got a good chance from here, has Lee.
They do like these pads, don't they?
Yeah, they can be a real nightmare at times if they go through them, but he's managed to steer that one away, so hopefully he gets it in.
It looked like it was coming the right way. It's turned around and gone back out again, and these fish are very, very powerful. The water's quite warm. There's been a lot of oxygen put in as well, and these things are really going to be scrapping, aren't they?
Yeah, they're proper scrappers on here, they really are. They certainly pull your arms out of the joints if he's playing one of these real big fish. I'd be a bit nervous at this early stage, I reckon, Rob, just a minute into the match.
That's it, you know, you need that fish to settle your nerves. We've all been in these competitions, and you want a fish pretty quickly to settle your nerves down, but one that quick almost takes you by surprise.
Yeah, like I say, virtually his first chuck, and he's into a fish. He's just got to keep it going now. Long time, he's 5 hours.
No stranger to this event. Of course, Lee was here last year. He's in the UK Angling Championships as well. Oh, and he's lost it. He'll be gutted.
Oh, dear.
Looking over at Jamie Hughes there, and he's pinging pellets and fishing very shallow.
Yeah, Jamie catches a lot of fish on this lake, shallow, and I would say he's probably the best shallow angler I've watched on this venue. A lot of people can't seem to get it to work, but Jamie always does. And he's ultra confident in his style. He's a very, very aggressive angler. Here we go, he's got a fish. It's only a small fish, but at least he's away. Be a skimmer. Here we are, a small skimmer.
very cool, calm and collected in these big competitions. And just before the competition started, we had the opportunity of sitting down and finding out a little bit more about the man himself.
My name is Jamie Hughes. I'm 31 years of age and I'm an angling coach from the Wirral. I've been fishing for probably 20 years. The competition, the importance of it at the moment, I believe it's possibly the competition that everyone wants to win. That, with Fishermania, these are the two main individual competitions in the country. It's what all aspiring match anglers want to be in the final of. If I won the money, I would at first jump in the lake. But after that, I'm not sure. It's so surreal to win a competition like this. The title means so much. I know everyone says this, but it really does. The title means everything. How does pressure affect me? You can either have a nice steady match and you catch a few fish and you're settling really well, or it tends to be in a more difficult match, you can become a little bit overcome by it.
Here we are now, peg 11, Gavin Butler, up by the island. We've seen that he's fishing a very different tactic to everybody else. He's on the method feeder and he's chucking over to the island, and that's not a bad tactic, is it, Andy?
Well, I think it's a bold move from Gavin, but I think it's a sensible move in the peg he's in and the company he's in. It's very, very different to what anybody else is doing. And
it was only a little over a week ago that Andy Finlay was in this peg, fishing exactly the same method, and he put 80 odd kilos on the bank. Did incredibly well, and there seemed to be a lot of good carp on that far margin.
Yeah, that far bank, the carp love that far bank and they like to get on it, and that's a carp he's playing now, is Gavin. And I just think his peg will get stronger for this. It could be a fantastic tactic for him. Could potentially win in this match.
Ben Fisk now, peg one, the quiet end of the lake, and he's just changed tactics. Come onto the pole and had a bite pretty quickly.
Yeah, he's been sat on a method feeder for a while and not had no bites, like a few of them down this end finding it hard work. He's been feeding his pole line, he's gone straight in and up one straight away.
Journalist for the Angling Times, this lad spends an awful lot of time covering events and said he was desperate to get into one of the big ones, and he's now in. Of course, he was in Parkdean last year, wasn't he? And he missed out on the...
By ounces.
Absolutely, I think it was 5 ounces. Oh, that's a decent fish.
That's a good fish, that's a good carp.
That is a good fish, he'll be very, very happy to get that one. And even though it's fairly quiet down here, these boys are in their own little competition with the section prizes that are on.
They've got £1,000 to fish for, first 6 pegs. So they're still going to be trying right to the very end, even if they think they're out of it, there's £1,000 there for up for grabs for them. I think these early pegs will show later on in the day, me, Robert. There's a lot of margin fish can get caught on these bottom pegs, and I think that's when we're going to see the best from these pegs.
I see Mike McMillan opposite there, and he's fishing down the edge already.
Yeah, Mike won the Open last Monday on here, and he caught a lot of fish down the edge, and he was ultra confident in catching down the edge, and said he was going to do it early. I think it's a bold move this early in the day.
The Elite Carp Series Poles. Stunning graphics. Aerospace carbon prepregs and resins. State-of-the-art machinery and mandrels. Poles available at 13 metres, 14.5 and 16 metre lengths. Patented Suncor and anti-friction finish. Unique reinforced Teflon joint system. PTFE slotted kits and tips. Comprehensive kit packages. The complete package. Elite Carp Series. Power and performance. Jurassic Classic Reel Lines. New from Maver. This Jurassic Classic copolymer is available in 300 metre match spools. Incredibly strong with controlled elasticity, meaning bite indication is superb. It also prevents hook pulls at the net. Combine this with a low diameter and fantastic knot strength, and you'll see why this impressive line will become a firm favourite. exceptional strength, low diameter and high knot strength. It's got the lot. For winners only.
Chris Hall's not having a bad time of it at the moment. Just going at the second hour and he's netting what looks to be a carp up there. Long way up from my poor old eyes to see, but he's been playing that one for quite a while. He's on a feeder.
Yeah, I think Chris is either fishing a feeder or a bomb. It's a really, really good bomb peg where Chris is. He's on the aerator, which is in the middle of the lake, and he holds a lot of fish that area, and he holds some big carp. And nobody else seems to be fishing a bomb or a feeder around him, so he's got it all to himself, that middle of the lake there, and seems to be making it pay with a few fish.
Looks like he's just going to get in there. Yeah, he's got it. He's happy with that, and that's a decent fish. That's a double hander.
Oh, it's a big fish, that.
Yeah, absolutely. That's going to rocket him right up there, because at the moment we were chatting just a few minutes ago between ourselves and we thought £15 might be it, and that's probably £8-9, that fish.
Yeah, so, it's definitely got pound signs in its eyes, that one, Rob.
Just looking up at Andy Fullylove there on peg 16. He's got a half-decent carp, but it's pretty quiet at the moment. One or two fish coming out from round the pond as we enter the second hour and things settle into the mid-stages of the race. Chris Cameron there landing another decent fish, and it looks like he's taking the lead at the moment. He's had quite a few decent carp over this last hour. It moved on to the method feeder, fishing about 30 yards out. Pink baits seem to be doing the trick for him. And that's a nice carp, 2.5-3 pound. We've seen Chris change tactics a couple of times. He's alternating between the bomb and pellet and the method feeder and boilie out there. He's had a little spell on the bomb and pellet, didn't catch anything. He's gone back on the feeder now.
Yeah, I've just had a little word with Chris, and he came down last week and caught a lot of fish on a pole line by casting a bomb over it. And he says you got better bites by fishing a bomb over it. No liners, no indications, and every bite he had was on, and that was his game plan. He was fishing bomber pellet over his pole line and a method feeder. And he admitted he got 40 pounds from me, Rob.
That's got to be up there at the moment. There's not many people that can claim 40 at this stage.
No, definitely not. I think he's definitely the leader at this stage. He's quite confident in what he's doing. I've had a nice word with him, and he thinks that bomber pellet line short over his pole will work for him later on.
Just looking around the pond, it seems to be a much quieter match than usual. There's nobody's running away with it, and there's not that many people catching, so it is going to be a sprint finish. They're all sort of trundling along, catching a few fish, but there's no massive weight yet. Andy Fullylove on the far side now. He is in a carp area, and he's catching carp. We've heard over the tannoy that he's had a few recently, and he's got to be challenging Chris Cameron towards the top now.
Yeah, I think it's nip and tuck between the pair of them. He's fished a dead simple match as Andy. He's sat there, he's done what he's good at. He catches a lot of fish on method feeder at Makings and that, where he goes. And he's just sat. And every now and again, it's gone round for him and he's caught a carp. And he's playing another one now, look. Nice and easy match for him. He's fished a good match, a good, confident match. In a method what he's confident in doing.
There's a little bit of a temptation to sort of try all sorts on a big occasion like this, isn't there? And sometimes it's better just to stick with what you know, get your game plan together and just go for it.
Yeah, I think a big match like this, Rob, you've got to set it out in your own mind what you're going to do. And, you know, if you start chopping and changing and doing different things, you just end up going nowhere and you end up chasing your own tail, really. And
so like you've got that one in, he netted that very quickly. Fish. That's a good fish, yeah. Yeah,
that is a big fish. That's a double figure fish he's got there.
That's a good fish he's just landed.
That's going to bring him right back into this, Rob, because I think he was, him and Chris were very close. Although Chris, I think, did have the lead on him, but.
Cheer of support coming from the distance.
Cheers of support from the distance here, Andy.
Gavin Butler's got one in the net over there. Just see him dropping a carp in.
Yeah, Gavin's been a steady performer. He started on a method feeder, and I thought that was going to be his game plan, but he's switched to pole and generally done a few things, but he's still kept a few fish ticking over in his net.
Lee Wright now, yeah. He's playing another fish. I've just saw a pellet waggler there, Andy. That's interesting.
Well, we were saying people were trying and chopping and changing and doing different methods. And I think that's the first fish we've actually seen on a pellet waggler. That'll be a big fish, that. It will be a big fish. If it's a pellet waggler fish, it will be a proper fish, no two ways about it.
He's had carp around there. He had a great early start. First hour, you've definitely pegged him in the lead. He had a couple of fish drop off, which wouldn't have done him very much good. And then the second hour, he seemed to hit the doldrums and just really it fell flat. But he might have found a method there, and that is a good fish.
Yeah, that's got to be £6 or £7 or more, that, Robbie. And like I said, the way this match is going, anybody can still win it with a few fish like that. You put a few fish together, and all of a sudden you're going to put £30 or £40 in your net, and you're back in this. That's a good fish.
Well, we've seen a few different people have a bit of a charge now. We're looking over at Andy Fully Love. Really, this third hour is his.
Is his, and like we were saying before, Robbie, he's done one thing. He's sat there. He's been confident in it. He's fished a method feeder, which he's really good at doing, and he's just stuck to his guns, and it's paying off for him.
Let's have a look how big that one is.
It's another big fish, Rob. Another really good fish.
Got a lot of support. There's a lot of cheers going around.
Yeah, a lot of support. Like I say, he's a fairly local lad to Larford. Fishes for Maver Midlands. All the Maver Midlands lads, we've seen him on the bank, and they're cheering on Andy, as well as Jamie Hughes himself. So, yeah, he'd be a popular winner, would Andy?
Almost like a game of tennis, this, Andy. We look over at Andy Fully Love, he catches one. We look back, Chris Cameron's caught one. While we're watching Chris Cameron, Andy Fully Love's back in again. And these two are literally fish for fish at the moment, with the odd one being thrown in by Lee Wright.
Yeah, it's real good, because they're like in a little bit of a triangular formation, and they can all see each other. They all know exactly what each other's catching. And a bit like a game of tennis between them both. Well, I'll catch one and you'll catch one.
Another good carp there.
Well, he'll have had that over his short line. Like I say, when I spoke to him, he said he found a nice little tactic to catch on a bomb over his pole line, feeding 6mm pellets, fishing an 8mm pellet, and he's finding a few fish on it.
Another fairly local lad, I think he's from Gloucester, and he's got a carp there that's leading him a bit of a merry dance just in front of his feet. He'll be anxious to get that one in, but at the same time, cool, calm and collected.
Yeah, Chris is a popular angler down here at Larford. Fishes quite a lot of the open matches. Knows this lake, knows the specimen lake, like back of his hand. So, you know, he knows what he's doing.
Ooh, that's a good unit. That's a unit. Ooh. Round of applause there from people watching.
Lovely. Nice 8-pounder.
Good fish he's got there. So, Chris is well up there. As we speak, Jamie Hughes is in another fish. Get on the long pole.
Jamie there, just about. In vision, and he's on the pole. That was his tactic all the way through.
Yeah, Jamie.
He's playing one.
Jamie fishes the pole on here. He doesn't do anything else. He's a real aggressive, positive angler, Jamie. He likes it to go his way and or no way.
To the winner today, it means so much. I mean, it's not all about winning the money, it's the prestige of winning this competition, you know?
Well, it's a very skillful sport, and it deserves the recognition that it should be getting.
To be crowned 2014 Match This Champion means so much to the angler, because it goes on his CV, it means he's got bigger opportunities for sponsorship. He wants to win that trophy, but he also is looking for a £60,000 payday, and that's what we're paying today.
This is
arguably the biggest match that any of these guys will ever fish. It's a once in a lifetime opportunity.
Peg wise, it could be one off a number of pegs on the venue today. The end pegs down here by the island are obviously the pegs that everybody wanted, but right here in the middle on the grass bank and opposite, the pegs that can win, and of course, any of your end pegs could feature in the prizes today.
The beauty with this event is that you've got club anglers in the final today as well, fishing against the country's best, so it's an opportunity for them as anglers to really raise their own profile individually and to get noticed and perhaps get sponsored. It can be a huge life-changing event for the angler that wins here today.
To be honest, I'm very, very proud on what we've achieved. I mean, this is its fourth year. It's grown in strength to strength. As I've said before, we're now paying a total prize fund of $72,000 today. That's made up, obviously, $60,000 to the winner, $5,000 to second, $3,000 to third, and then we're paying £1,000 every six pegs. So it's a huge pot. How do I feel about the event? I think the prestige of being involved in such a major event is great.
It's a big day for the anglers here, but it's a big day for the staff as well. It's a big day for everyone involved.
Fishing is very underrated. It's not picked up enough. We're here to try and raise that profile, and hopefully this event will do that. The Monkey Match Reel. A sensational new match reel from Maver that weighs in at a featherweight 280 grams. Engineering at its highest level with a smooth and precise drag system. Spring-loaded round line clip that minimises line damage. Titanium-plated roller, eliminating line twist. Eight aerospace stainless steel bearings. Intelligent oscillating system, providing for that perfect line lay. The Monkey Match Reel. Technology before its time. The Maver MXI side footplate fits all Maver seat boxes with wheel kit attachments and other boxes too. Can be used on the left or right side of the box. Can be used as a footrest when fishing down the edges. Also great for fishing the long pole, as it definitely corrects poor posture. Supplied with 2x25mm legs and quality carry bag.
Well, we're now at the halfway stage in proceedings, and Andy, it's been quite an exciting match so far. Fairly steady at the moment. We think there's going to be three lads in it.
Yeah, it has. It's been a steady start for a lot of anglers, but these three definite leaders at this stage, Chris Cameron, Andy Fullylove, and Lee Wright, they're all much of a muchness, £40, £45. But I still think anybody can win this match, Rob, because it's that close.
Well, that's really actually is. Quite a low weight for this lake as well. We know that a lot of the time there's 100-pound bags to be had, no problem whatsoever. What is noticeable to me is this is the first time we've ventured over into what they call a burbank, which is the split between the match lake and the main specimen lake. And it's cold over here.
It is cold.
Were looking from there, you know, you can see hats and hoodies.
Yeah.
We need them.
Yeah, we need them. It's really cold. It's a cold wind that's now blowing onto this bank. But I still think them fish are going to feed, and I still think they're going to come in the edges, Rob. And like I said, a lot of people can still win this match. I'd be I'd still be like thinking to myself, I'm going to win this. I can still win £60,000 here with these margin fish.
Well, that's one of the things where a match is quite low in weight. You know, people think, oh, it's not as exciting as it usually is. Mm. You know what? It's more exciting because everybody is still in it, because £45 is actually four decent fish.
Yeah.
And that can happen in a short period of time.
Yeah, four decent bites down your edge. It can happen that in 10 minutes. And 10 minutes and you're back in the race and you're on for the £60,000 check. Quite easy. Quite easy.
Lee Carey's been very quiet so far, but I'm just looking across the lake at him now, and he's playing a half-decent fish. And just before we started this chat, he landed one as well. So, you know, a man that's caught nothing in the first 2 hours has suddenly now put a couple of fish on the bank. Is it going to be a late charge from Lee?
Like we were saying, Robert, it could be a late charge from quite all 24 of these anglers could put in a late charge. But, well, he has had a few fish, and he's now starting to catch a couple. And it's funny, he's next to Chris Cameron, who's caught really well.
Darren Cox just netting one, and Darren's been quiet.
Yeah, the further we've gone down the lake, down here, Robbie, he's got quieter, but he's just had a fish on a long pole. But just spoke to one or two people along this bank, they're saying now they're starting to see one or two fish come into the razors. So it could be anybody's this match now. Like, we've spoke about it before, most of it, haven't we? If these margin fish feed, oh, it could happen.
Just looking across at Lee Carey there now, and he's had a very, very quiet first couple of hours. We're struggling to get a bite, landed one or two little ones, but you know what, last 15 minutes I've seen him net a couple of fish, and this looks like it might be half decent as well.
Yeah, it's another good fish. We saw him just land one just before that. He's gone straight back in and had another. So things look like they're starting to happen for Lee. He's next to Chris Cameron, who's caught some fish, so he's obviously fishing that area.
Lee's one of those danger men that you can't ever write off. You know, he's England international.
Yeah.
So he's in the squad. Yeah. He obviously knows what he's doing. The fact that he's not catching fish means that there's none there. Yeah. If they turn up, he's going to catch them. Yeah.
If they turn up, like I say, England international, he's going to catch them. He's going to get them in fast. He's going to be well up there with everybody else. So all to play for. All to play for.
Throw a curveball in now, Andy, and talk about this man, Simon Skelton, third in this event last year. He's not really featured so far, but I've been watching him feed his edge line. He's gone down there for the first look with an hour and a half left. With an hour and a half left on the clock, he's gone for his first look down the edge. And look at that, boom, he's in.
Got one. Yeah, Simon knows how to catch these margin fish on here. Did it last year, was nowhere, and then all of a sudden crept in and managed to sneak third place. Yeah, we stood it back in there. We've seen him feed his margin. We've seen a couple of signs and swirls at these fish there. So they're showing an interest already down the side. And like you say, he got one first choke.
It's a lovely margin down there as well. He's got his pallet. There we are. That's a decent common.
That is a good common.
But we look down at his edge now. He's got the platform that's slightly underwater. He's got an overhanging bush. He's got some potamogeton pads there as well. And the carp are going to love it round there. Andy fully loving to a little one now. It's a skimmer, and that's not necessarily a good sign, is it? He was on the carp earlier.
Yeah, he was catching
has
carp
it dried
earlier.
Up?
It's not a good sign. I think these carp are now moving, Rob. I think they're now coming closer to the bank. And I think there's going to be some tactic changes needed shortly between a few of these anglers, because things are starting to happen.
Which carp they want now? Anything that's silver. Bit of a waste of time, isn't it? That's what you use in the doldrum times through the middle of the match, just to keep your weight up, but it's carp now.
Yeah, anything silver ain't going to win you gold.
Simon Skelton, down the edge, boom, carp on.
Didn't catch a lot last year, came from Norway, caught him down the edge, he's done it again. He's doing it again.
Bit of a smile there as he had his name mentioned.
Yeah, a bit of a smile, he had his name mentioned, but... That's a big fish, Rob.
Yeah.
Like we were saying earlier, the proper pullers on here, Rob, they pull your arms off.
And he's not joking for anybody that's not done it. Holding a 16-metre pole with an angry carp on the end of the elastic, which is at full stretch, is a bit of a nerve-wracking experience, I can assure you. Quite calm. Reckons he's got the bottle. Yeah. Yeah, he doesn't crack under pressure, and this is a man that we spoke to yesterday.
My name's Simon Skelton from Melton Mowbray. I'm 34 and I run my own plumbing business. Been fishing since I've been about 10 with my brother and my dad. They're the ones that got me interested, just on the local lakes really. To get into the final for the second year running, it has become a very big competition for me. It's a lot of money, and if I did win, I really wouldn't know. One of the things I'd probably do is take my family to Disney World, and then I don't know. I really don't know. It's a lot of money to be thinking about. Last year was just, the day went really quick, and I think this year I'll do the same. I'll just try and revel in it a little bit more this year and have the same result, if not better.
Is a man that
that's a proper fish.
That is massive. I just wanted to hold back and see that. Well,
oh, well done.
That's a game changer.
Yeah, well done.
That now puts him from somebody that might be into contention to someone that is absolutely well and truly in contention. Well, there's the bookie's favourite, and we've heard that name mentioned quite a few times over the tannoy today. It's Jamie Hughes. We're looking across the pond and he's playing another one. And I think you mentioned it earlier, Andy. He's not necessarily going out and catching massive fish, but what he's doing is he's catching fish.
Yeah, he constantly puts fish in the net, Jamie. You know, you draw at the side of him, you think, I'm going to be really close, I might. And he's miles in front of you. And he just constantly puts fish in the net. And while ever something's going in your keep net, you're adding to your final weight. And that's what Jamie does, and that's what he's very, very, very good at.
Chris Cameron now, and another one that's been regularly mentioned. And we seem to hear these same names mentioned all the time because they're on it and they're steadily just plodding along. And Chris, throughout the course of this competition, has been alternating between a bomb and pellet and the feeder. There we are, he's got that one in. Oh, the nose was in and the tail was hanging over the end. That means it's quite long, so useful fish. Another carp, £5-ish.
Yeah, it's another good fish he's got. Same thing again, he keeps adding to his weight. He's constantly putting something in the net.
Just looking down there at Perry Stone, couple of pegs down. He's into a fish.
Yeah, Perry's, that's his second fish in two chucks. So, all of a sudden, same thing. Like we're saying, fish are starting to feed.
Interestingly, as he's playing that, I'm looking over at Jamie Hughes, who's playing a carp. And he's not had a lot of carp. He's been mainly on the skimmers, but he's definitely got a carp
he's
on
there. He's definitely
now.
Got a carp on there. Different colour elastic. He's going for it now, Jamie. He knows he's behind, but like I said, a real positive angle and gives it 110% every match.
There's the net, it doesn't miss with him.
No, bang. He normally gets him first time.
That's a decent carp. That'll make a big difference, that'll throw
that's
him up there.
Fish.
Oh, yes, yes. Meanwhile, Perry Stone's still being led a fair merry dance by that creature down there. It's been under his feet for a good 5 minutes now.
Yeah, he's having a bit of a tug of war with that one. And by the looks of things, it'll be a real big fish. It'll be a proper carp. Same thing, he's in the area where they're likely to catch him. I think he's actually fishing a bomb, is Perry. As we walked past, he was having a little chuck with a pellet wagger. He's a fantastic pellet wagger hanging, but I think he's gone on a bomb.
Yeah, there it is. Oh, it's a big fish. He can't get that in there. He's got it in.
Oh, well done. That's a beautiful fish.
To coin the words of a film, he needs a bigger boat for that one. Yeah. That's going to snap his net if he doesn't double hand that one up. Look at that. That's double figure plus. That's 12, 14 pound even.
Yeah, we'll put some more barrels in that one to slow that one down, I think.
Wow. There we are, Lee Wright, another man that's no stranger to top-end competitions. He was here last year. He fishes in the UK Championships on the main big boys circuit. And I caught up with him just to find out a little bit more about the man himself.
My name's Lee Wright. I'm 30 years old, from Sawley in Long Eaton, Nottingham. And I've been a floor layer for about 15 years. Been fishing since I was about four. So a long time really. To me, this competition's it's very important. It means the world to me, it really does. It's tough to get into finals like this because there's so many good anglers. There's a lot of pressure to get through different venues. You need to draw good pegs. But to get there, it's always, you know, amazing. It's an amazing feeling. I tend to try and keep my cool as much as I can. Just stay calm, just try and stay focused on the actual fishing itself and just try and do your best really, that's all you can do.
this one comes in.
Oh, it's
in,
proper,
it
it's proper
in.
Hooked, it's a big one.
And that is a unit. That's the biggest fish that we've seen of the day so far. And that will put Lee Wright right back in it.
Introducing the world's most technically advanced pole production. Manufactured in Italy to exacting standards by way of design, patented technology, and innovation. The Signature Series are produced from our own unique carbon format prepregs, incorporating our super toughened epoxy resins. State-of-the-art machinery is utilised to produce poles with strength, rigidity, and perfect balance. At 13 metres, the Signature 800 weighing a featherweight 750 grams. Unique innovation includes our patented sun core and anti-friction finishes, enabling the angler to ship at speed in all weather conditions. Each kit is factory fitted with quality PTFE side slots and PTFE tips. Fighting number 5 and 6 sections are supplied for fishing short when the strike is severe. In all, a very comprehensive kit package is supplied and all housed in a quality hold all. Signature, simply making winning easier. New from Maver, the Slotty Ready Rig Range. The new Maver Slotty Pole Rigs are of the highest quality pole rigs available. Designed by Maver's experienced consultants, specifically for UK commercial fisheries, where strength and reliability is paramount. Utilising the finest top quality components, including the best-selling MT hooks, smart mono and innovative sloppy floats.
Chris Cameron's absolutely flying at the moment, Andy. Oh. If he puts his foot down, he's got this in the bag now. I'm going to stand up and say that. He's
definitely in the home straight now, isn't he? and everybody's trying to catch him. And like I say, he's still constantly just keep putting a fish in the net. So they're all playing catch up.
Simon Skelton on a full reach there, Andy. The old pole's bending and he's been pulled around a bit there.
Yeah, he has been pulled. I feel a bit sorry for Simon. He's hooked some fish and lost a few fish, but he's battling one now, like, so he's still fighting hard, mate. He's still trying to catch his way back into it.
Let's just look at these contenders and we'll skip one peg to his left. And we look over to his left on the far side, and that is Andy Fullilove.
Andy Fullilove playing a fish.
And he is playing a fish. That's it. It's very nearly in there. That's
yeah,
a splash.
It's in.
It's in. There's a little ripple of applause. That's
a good
it.
Fish, Rob, again.
So let's just have a look at a man with a lot of concentration on his face now. If he's not at the front of the pack, he's very, very close to it, and he knows it. He's 10 minutes away from a potential £60,000. It's Chris Cameron. He's your favourite. We've seen him catch a few recently. What's going to be going through his mind now?
Well, you can see he's still he's trying to catch down the edge. He's tried and tried, and he's only had one fish there, but he's caught enough through the day rope.
There they are.
You know, there we go. We talked that one in. We talked that one on for him.
It's like a game of tennis because we look one way, and we've got Cameron catching left, right, and centre. We look the other way, and we've got Wright catching left, right, and centre.
Yeah. It's like we said earlier, Rob, we know, and we all know that we're going to run out of time. And Lee's trying to get that fish in as quick as possible so he can get out and get another one. He's going for goal now.
Oh,
he's having a swipe.
He's got
there you go, he's got it. He'll be back out there like lightning. He can't get down his edge quick enough now.
I think he knows that he's got a chance at this, but he's just behind.
Yeah.
You know, when you watch the difference between the two of them, one is incredibly calm, the other one is panicking
a
little bit.
The other one is panicking.
And that's not down to nerves, that's because one knows he's got to up his ante a little bit and sprint a bit more. That's a good fish, there's a lot of elastic out there.
Yeah, he'll take his time with this fish, Rob. He's not going to rush it at this stage, there's no point. He ain't got to, he's leading. He's just going to take his time and net it.
He's down to the top two.
Down to the top two, he's onto his puller kit,
He's got a control over it now, so this is when he can start pulling a little bit harder. Yeah. Get that fish in as quickly as possible because I'm not quite sure if everyone else can see it. I can, just looking over the edge, there's fish feeding in his edge.
Yeah, you can see him swirling, can't we? They're there now for him.
There's another one ready there. He's got to get this one in the bag first, of course, or it's not going to count. But as soon as he's got it in, he'll be straight back out there trying to get another one.
It's a big fish, Rob. We've just seen it. It's a big fish. Oh, there we go.
That's him.
That's it. Oh, it's a good fish.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, that's £8.
Net in the water for Fully Love. Net in the water for Cameron. Hard to know where to look for everybody concerned here at the moment. Well, I'm going to keep my eye on Chris Cameron because he's been...
Chris is in.
Just a little bit quicker, he's got it. Let's flip back now and have a look on the other side. We've just seen that that's a decent fish for Chris Cameron. That's probably another one towards double figures. Meanwhile, on the other side, Andy Fully Love is still playing his fish. Now, that's very, very interesting. That's run rate now because Andy Fully Love hooked his fish significantly earlier than Chris Cameron did. Chris has hooked it, landed it, netted it, got it in the bag and got back out before Andy's netted his.
Here we go.
Let's have a look. Oh, it's a big one.
And in the bag for Andy Fully Love. Come on, Andy!
That's another good one.
That's a big fish.
Well, they probably cancelled each other out, those two.
Yeah.
They were very, very close.
Yeah, they were both very, very close fish.
Let's just finish off now looking at this man. It is Chris Cameron. He's got three red dead maggots, and there we are. That's over. The hooter is now blown, and somebody's going to be 60 grand richer. Andy, what do you reckon? 5 hours went quick.
Yeah, 5 hours went quick. Fantastic last hour and a half of the match when a few people were in the race and caught a lot of fish, and we're just trying to catch people up. Brilliant, brilliant match.
They've done everything they can now. Who do you think's done enough?
I think Chris Cameron. I think he's held his nerve and kept his bottle right while the end, and he's had a couple of fish late. I think he's got it.
He's looked a very, very cool and calm customer all the way throughout, but now it's not up to us, it's not up to them, it's up to the scalesman to tell us. Kilos the lead as we move into the peg of Lee Wright. It's peg 6. 11 kilo 160 the first way. 11 kilos 160 second way. Again, the net is mainly carp.
11 kilo 400
11 kilo 400 22 kilo 560 He needs 3 kilo now to go into the lead.
6 kilo 600
That is 29 kilos 160 That puts Lee Wright into the lead. Here we have it. This is the one that we need to know about. This is Chris Cameron, peg 8. 29 kilos currently in the lead. There's some decent carp in there. That net alone is a good day's fishing. It's also a great start towards 60,000 quid.
11 kilo 320
All the fish, of course, go back in again. None the worse for their ordeal. Once again, a whole bag of carp there. 11 kilo 320 the first way for Chris Cameron. I'm just waiting for the digital scales to settle so we know the reading is exact. We need a drum roll.
16 kilos 080
is the official score on that. That is 27 kilos 400. It needs 2 kilos to take the overall lead. That is clearly above 2 kilos. More like
15 kilo 820.
15. More like 15 kilo 820 there, according to the scalesman. And the final weigh there for Chris Cameron, 43 kilos 220. That is in the lead. 43 220.
43 kilos.
Well, this is Andy Fullilove, and this is Peg 16. 27, 920 at the moment. He's not going to take first, he might take second.
4 kilos 460.
That means Andrew Fullilove is 32 kilos 380. It's not enough to take the lead, it is enough to take second place. We've got one more. 17. Perry Stone now, Peg, 17. A total now of 24,240. Is this the last way? If this is the last way, it's a battle for second, and it looks like Chris has got first. Let's just have a look at Chris now. Anxious moments now, quite tense. Need to find out what this is. It looks like it's going to take second place. 13 kilo 120. That gives Perry Stone 37,360. 37,360. That takes second place. We think there is no one else down there that can beat our current leader. That's it. We can announce officially that you are the Match This champion. You are 60 grand the richer. Fair dues. Now, I'm not letting go because there is one thing that you've got to do. So, over to you. Chris, hold it there. And that was it for another year, with Chris Cameron taking the top slot, a little over 5 kilograms ahead of Perry Stone, who in turn was 5 kilos ahead of third-placed Andy Fullilove. Chris, 60 grand richer. How does that feel?
Brilliant. Not quite sunk in yet, but it will, I'm sure. Got a few ideas what I'm going to spend it on already now, so I'm getting there. Starting on the pole, catch what you can, and then go on to the bomb or the method, both lines, and then alternate with the bomb on a short line and the method on a long line, and just to keep the fish coming. And then as the day's gone on, I've just gone shorter and shorter.
All the way through, you've looked very cool, calm and collected. And I must say, mate, for a guy that's just won 60 grand, you look very cool and calm now.
That's the way I am. I'm always the same. I don't really get excited, I suppose. It's fishing to me, which I love doing, so.
What does tomorrow hold for you? Is it going to be a hangover?
No. Probably go fishing again. So that's about it. I don't really drink a great deal, so I might have a few. That's about it, I suppose.
Enter the unique S4 Z-frame seat box. European patented four-leg system. Anti-memory, two-colour foam seat and pole support. Large extendable 30mm legs. And adjustable mud feet. State-of-the-art clip system, opening front and back. One front and one side spirit levels. free flow sliding cassette foot plate. Two round 30mm anodized accessory legs. 40mm stacking module with lid, handle, and two winder trays. £150 worth of free accessories, including spray bar, adjustable side tray, keep net, and umbrella arm. Supplied in a multitude of colours, including black, white, green, and mango main frames and seat trims. It stands alone.